Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Now in this video I'm going to solve a few questions from previous year's 12th board paper. This is from the chapter Current Electricity. So in 2018 there was a question: two electric bulbs P and Q have their resistances in the ratio 1:2. They are connected in series across a battery. Find the ratio of power dissipation of these bulbs. Okay, now you have two resistors connected in series, okay, R1 and R2, and this is combination is connected to a source of battery. Okay, so this is a battery. Now find the ratio of power dissipation. Now see, for power there are two formula: P is equal to I square R and P is equal to V square by R. Okay, now for this formula, P is inversely proportional to R, but the condition is V is constant. Now in this formula, P is directly proportional to R provided I is constant. Now in series, if the two resistors here, R1 and R2, are the two resistors and they are connected in series, so obviously they will carry the same current. So this term is constant. So if this term is constant, it implies power is directly proportional to R. Okay, in series, resistors in series, current is same. If resistors are in parallel, potential will be same. In that case, we'll be using this formula. But here, since the resistors are in series, we'll be using P is equal to I square R. I is the current, so P is directly proportional to R. So this gives P1 by P2. So that is the power dissipated across the two resistors, ratio of the power. It is equal to R1 by R2. Now in the question, it is given that R1 by R2, it is equal to 1:2. Okay. So it implies power ratio is also 1:2. So this is the final answer. Now, there was one more question. In 2018, a 10 volt cell of negligible internal resistance is connected in parallel across a battery of EMF 12 volt and internal resistance 38 ohm. Find the current in the circuit. So this is a 10 volt battery and this is a 200 volt battery with internal resistance 38 ohm. This internal resistance of this cell is negligible, 10 volt cell of negligible internal resistance. Okay. Now we are asked to find the current in the circuit. Okay. Now suppose I is the current in the circuit. Okay. Now if I apply Kirchhoff rule. Okay. So this current is flowing from this side to this side. So this is high potential. This is low potential. So we'll be here using Kirchhoff loop rule. So this is I times 38 current into resistance with a negative sign, because current is flowing from high potential to low potential. So there is a potential loss. Then from negative terminal to positive terminal, there is a potential gain. So that is plus 200. Then from high potential to low potential, loss minus 10. This is equal to 0. Total potential drop across a closed loop is 0. Okay. So this gives 38 I is equal to 190. Okay. So that is I is equal to 190 divided by 38. So this is 38 5 times. So that is 5 ampere. So current in the circuit is 5 ampere. So this is the final answer. Now in 2017, there was a question: nichrome and copper wires of same length and radius are connected in series. Current I is passed through them. Which wire gets heated up more? Okay. So you have nichrome wire N and suppose this is copper wire, and they are connected in series and current I is passed. Okay. Which wire gets heated up more? Okay. Now heat generated in a wire, it is given by the relation I square R T. Okay. I can also use H is equal to V square by R into T. Okay. Now again, I will be using this relation, not this relation, because in this case nichrome and copper, these are connected in series, so they will carry same current. So same current means this term will be constant. Okay, now here we have the term resistance R, T is the time. Now this R, we know that R is equal to rho L by A. Okay, so if I substitute this value over here, this becomes H is equal to I square rho L by A into T. Okay, A is the cross-sectional area, so that is pi R square, where R is the radius. Now in the question, it is given that both nichrome and copper, they have same length and radius. So this length is same, radius is same. So cross-sectional area is also same. Current, they are in series, so current is also same. So this implies H, it is directly proportional to the resistivity. So heat produced will be directly proportional to resistivity. Okay, now out of nichrome and copper, nichrome has higher resistivity. Okay, so resistivity of nichrome, it is greater than resistivity of copper. So since resistivity is more, heat produced will be more in nichrome. So heat produced in nichrome will be greater than heat produced in copper. So this is the answer. Now another question from 2017. The potential difference across a given resistor is altered so that heat produced per second increases by a factor of 9. By what factor does the applied potential difference change? Okay. Now for this, see, they have asked the relationship between heat, rate of heat produced and potential. So that is, rate of heat is power. Okay. So power, it is equal to V square by R. Okay, so this is the rate of heat produced. Okay, now they have said that the potential difference across a given resistor is altered so that heat produced per second increases by a factor of 9. So the new heat produced rate is 9P, and that is equal to new voltage V dash square by R. The resistance remains same. Okay, now if I divide these two quantities, what do I get? I get 9P by P is equal to, this is V dash square by R divided by V square by R. So this RR cancels out. So this is V dash square by V square. Okay, this P and P cancels out. So now if I take square root on both sides, I get V dash by V is equal to 3, or V dash is equal to 3V. So the potential, by what factor does the applied potential change? So it will be increased by 3 times. Potential has to be increased by 3 times. So this is the answer. Now this is important thing I want to say with regard to this particular question, that I have seen the solution of this question in one website on a prominent coaching institute, and in another website of an online tutorial. Now in both the websites, they have got the same solution, but the procedure is totally wrong. They have used the value of this R to be 6 ohm. Okay, but nowhere in the question they have given this R to be 6 ohm. Okay, so you need to be careful while seeing the answers from solved any solution website or any book where some solved solutions are given. So just look for the answers logically. Okay, so this is the correct answer. Now there was one more numerical in 2017. Now the numerical is based on this circuit. Now here we have a 12 volt cell of internal resistance 2 ohm. Okay, now across this, a resistance R equal to 4 ohm is connected. This is a ammeter and this is a voltmeter. Okay, and we are asked to calculate the voltmeter and ammeter reading. Now this ammeter, it measures the current in this circuit. Now in this circuit, if you see, this 2 ohm and this 4 ohm, they are in series. So total resistance is 6 ohm. So total resistance R equivalent, it is 4 plus 2, that is equal to 6 ohm. And this potential source is 12 volt. Okay, V is equal to 12 volt. So this gives current I is equal to V by R equivalent. So that is equal to 12 divided by 6. So that is equal to 2 ampere. So the ammeter reading, it will be 2 ampere. Okay, now they have also asked the voltmeter reading. Okay, for this voltmeter, now for voltmeter, we know, we can use this formula, V is equal to E minus IR. Okay, where E is the EMF, I is the strength of the current. Okay, so E here, it is 12 volt, this is 12 volt. So this is 12 minus 2 into 2. 2 is the internal resistance, and 2 is also the strength of the current. So this is 12 minus 4, that is equal to 8 volt. Okay, so the voltmeter reading will be 8 volt. Now moving to 2016, there was one numerical when a 5 volt potential difference, PD potential difference, is applied across a wire of length 0.1 meter, the drift speed of the electrons is 2.5 into 10 power minus 4 meter per second. If the electron density in the wire is 8 into 10 power 28 per meter cube, calculate the resistivity of the material. Okay, now for this particular problem, we need to use the Ohm's law. Okay, now Ohm's law, see, there are two forms of Ohm's law. One is V is equal to IR and the other one is E is equal to rho J. Okay, here E is the strength of the electric field, rho is the resistivity and J is the current density. So we'll be using this relation to solve this question. Okay, now E, strength of electric field, it is potential drop per unit length, okay, and resistivity rho, and what is current density? Current density is current per unit area. Okay, now this current is related to drift velocity by the relation I is equal to NAE VD, okay, where N is the number density of free electrons, A is the cross-section area, E is the charge of electron, and VD is the drift velocity. So if I substitute this value over here, it is rho, I is NAE VD divided by A. So this AA cancels out. Okay, so this gives rho, we need to find the value of rho, calculate the resistivity of the material. So this rho is the resistivity. So rho is equal to V by LNE VD. Okay, now what is V? V is 5 volt. So this is 5 volt. Okay, and what is L? L is the length is 0.1 meter. Okay, N is number density of free electrons, that is 8 into 10 power 28 per meter cube. Okay, E is the charge of electron, that is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. Okay, and VD is the drift velocity, and that is 2.5 into 10 power minus 4. So this multiplied by 2.5 into 10 power minus 4 meter per second. Okay. Now, if you substitute these values, then you get rho is equal to 1.56 into 10 power minus 5 ohm meter. Okay. I have done this calculation using calculator. You may check it yourself, but this is how you need to proceed. Okay. The essence of this question is Ohm's law in this form. This is also called the vector form of Ohm's law. There was another numerical in the year 2016 based on this circuit. The question reads, the two identical cells of EMF 1.5 volt each joined in parallel supply energy to an external circuit consisting of two resistances 7 ohm each joined in parallel. A very high resistance voltmeter reads the terminal voltage of cells to be 1.4 volt. Calculate the internal resistance of each cell. So these are the two identical cells of 1.5 volt each and same internal resistance. Okay. Now this is connected, they are in parallel, and this combination is connected to parallel combination of two resistors 7 ohm each. Now a voltmeter of very high resistance is connected across this cell combination. Calculate the internal resistance of each cell. Okay. Now we know that if you have two cells, okay, like this, suppose this is E1, this is R1 internal resistance, this is E2, and this is cell of internal resistance R2. Okay, now this two cells in parallel, this can be represented as a single cell of EMF E equivalent and internal resistance R equivalent. Okay, where this E equivalent, it is given by the formula E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. This is the equivalent EMF, and the equivalent resistance, they are in parallel. So equivalent resistance R equivalent will be R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay. Now here, since the two cells have identical internal resistance, the cells are in fact identical. So this R1 is equal to, I can write R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R. So if I substitute this value over here, I get R equivalent is equal to R by 2. And here if I substitute R1 and R2 as R, I get E equivalent is equal to E. Okay. Now what is the value of E? E is 1.5 volt. So this E is 1.5 volt. So equivalent EMF of this cell combination, it is 1.5 volt. Okay. Now I need to find the internal resistance. Okay, how do I do that? See, first I will find the current that is flowing in this circuit. Okay, now this, since this combination is reduced to a single cell, so this circuit can be redrawn as, see, this is 7 and 7. So this 7 ohm, 7 ohm, they are in parallel. So the equivalent resistance will be 1 by R equal to 1 by 7 plus 1 by 7. So that gives this to be 3.5 ohm. So equivalent resistance of this part is 3.5 ohm. Okay, so let me redraw this circuit. So this is 3.5 ohm. These two, 1.5 volt. These two are reduced to 1.5 volt. R by 2. This two are reduced to R by 2. Okay, and this is connected to a voltmeter. Okay, so this circuit has been redrawn like this. Okay, so now for this part of the circuit, these two resistors, see, current will flow like this, like this. This voltmeter has very high resistance, so in this part there is no current, so current will flow like this. So that means both 3.5 and R by 2, they will carry the same current, so they are in series. So the current in this circuit will be, I is equal to, potential drop is 1.5 divided by 3.5 plus R by 2. Okay, so if I take this 2 over here, it goes over here, so it is 3 divided by 7 plus R. So this is the value of I. Okay, now for this voltmeter, the voltmeter reading can be found by using the formula V is equal to E minus IR. Okay, E is this 1.5 volt, so V is equal to, E is 1.5 minus I is 3 divided by 7 plus R, and this R is the R equivalent, and that is equal to R by 2. Okay, and in the question it is given that the voltmeter reads this voltage as 1.4 volt, so that means this value, it is equal to 1.4. Okay, so now here only R is the unknown quantity, all the other quantities are known. Now if you solve this, you will get the value of R to be equal to 0.5 ohm. Okay, I will give a link to download these solutions in PDF format so that you can easily understand these things. Now coming to 2015, there was a question, a potential difference V is applied across a conductor of length L, diameter D. How is the drift velocity Vd of charge carriers in the conductor affected when V is halved, that is potential is halved, length is doubled, L is the length, D diameter is halved. Justify your answer. Okay, now for this we know that the drift velocity, it is given by the expression E tau by M. Okay, this is the magnitude of drift velocity. E is the charge of electron, small e, capital E is the strength of electric field, tau is the average relaxation time, and M is the mass of the electron. Okay, now this strength of electric field, it is related to potential and length of the conductor by the relation E is equal to V by L. Okay, so now if I make this substitution over here, I get Vd, the drift velocity, is equal to E V tau by M L. Okay, now they were asked, what happens to the drift velocity when V is halved? Now when V is halved, okay, this obviously, see, Vd, it is directly proportional to V. Okay, so that means when V is halved, Vd is also halved. Okay, next they have asked, what happens when L is doubled? So as you can see, Vd is inversely proportional to the length of the conductor. Okay, now if length of the conductor is doubled, again Vd will be halved. Okay, then they have asked, what happens if D is halved? So as you can see, Vd is independent of the diameter or the radius of the conductor. So if D is halved, there is no change in the value of the drift velocity of the charge carriers. So these are the things you are supposed to write in this. Now in 2014, there was a question based on, again, drift velocity. Estimate the average drift speed of conduction electrons in a copper wire of cross-sectional area 2.5 into 10 power minus 7 meter square carrying a current of 2.7 ampere. Number density of free electrons is 9 into 10 power 28 per meter cube. Okay, now the strength of current, it is related to drift velocity by the relation I is equal to NAE Vd. Okay, n is the number density of free electrons, a is the cross section area, e is the charge of electron, vd is the drift velocity. So this gives vd is equal to I by n a e. Okay, now strength of current, in this case it is I is the strength of current, it is given is 2.7 ampere. Okay, n is 9 × 10^28 per meter cube. Okay, cross section area, it is 2.5 × 10⁻⁷ meter square. Okay, and E, the charge of electron, that we know, it is 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulomb. Okay, now if you calculate all these values, you will get this to be 7.5 × 10⁻⁴ meter per second. Okay, now if there is a question involving drift velocity, just see this, that you don't get the drift velocity to be very high. It will always be of the order of few millimeter per second. You will never get an answer where the drift velocity is 2 meter per second or 20 meter per second, like that. Okay, so while getting the answer, just check whether you are getting this as 10⁻⁴, just for rechecking the calculation. Okay, so these are the solutions from 2014 to 2018 from the chapter Current Electricity, and I hope this benefits you in your performance for the forthcoming board examinations. So my best wishes to you. Good luck.